Reason number 5, we know God exists because He pursues us. He's constantly initiating and seeking for us to come to Him. Supposedly you are an atheist. And like many atheists, the issue of people believing in God bothered you greatly. What is it about atheists that you would spend so much time, attention, and energy refuting something that you don't believe even exists? What causes you to do that? When you are an atheist, you attributed your intentions as caring for those poor, delusional people to help them realize their hope was completely ill-founded. To be honest, you also had another motive. As you challenged those who believe in God, you were deeply curious to see if they could convince you otherwise. Part of your quest was to become free from the question of God. If you could conclusively prove to believers that they were wrong, then the issue is off the table, and you would be free to go about your life. But you didn't realize that the reason the topic of God weighs so heavily on your mind was because God was pressing the issue. We have come to find out that God wants to be known. He created us with intention that we would know Him. He has surrounded us with evidence of Himself, and He keeps the question of His existence squarely before us. It was as if you couldn't escape thinking about the possibility of God. In fact, the day you chose to acknowledge God's existence, your prayer began with, "Okay, you win." It might be that the underlying reason atheists like you are bothered by people believing in God is because God is actively pursuing them. You are not the only one who has experienced this. Malcolm Muggeridge, socialist and philosophical author, wrote, "I had a notion that somehow, besides questing, I was being pursued." C.S. Lewis said he remembered night after night feeling whenever my mind left it even for a second from my work, the steady, unrelenting approach of him whom I so earnestly desired not to meet. I gave in and admitted that God was God and knelt and prayed. Perhaps that night the most dejected and reluctant convert in all of England. Lewis went on to write a book titled "Surprised by Joy as a Result of Knowing God." I too had no expectations other than rightfully admitting God's existence. Yet over the following several months, I became amazed by His love for me. Reason number 6, unlike any other revelation of God, Jesus Christ is the clearest, most specific picture of God revealing Himself to us. Why Jesus? Look throughout the major world religions and you will find that Buddha, Muhammad, Confucius, and Moses all identify themselves as teachers or prophets. None of them ever claimed to be equal to God. Surprisingly, Jesus did. That is what sets Jesus apart from all the others. He said God exists and you are looking at Him. Though He talked about His Father in heaven, it was not from the position of separation, but of very close union, unique to all humankind. Jesus said that anyone who had seen Him had seen the Father. Anyone who believed in Him believed in the Father. He said, "I am the light of the world. Who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." He claimed attributes belonging only to God, to be able to forgive people of their sin, free them from habits of sin. Give people a more abundant life and give them eternal life in heaven. Unlike other teachers who focused people on their words, Jesus pointed people to himself. He did not say, "Follow my words and you will find truth." He said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me." What proof did Jesus give for claiming to be divine? He did what people cannot do. Jesus performed miracles. He healed people, blind, crippled, deaf, even raised a couple of people from the dead. He had power over objects, created food out of thin air, enough to feed crowds of several thousands of people. He performed miracles over nature, walked on top of a lake, commanding a raging storm to stop for some friends. People everywhere follow Jesus because he constantly met their needs, doing the miraculous. He said, "If you do not want to believe what I'm telling you, you should at least believe in me based on the miracles you are seeing." Jesus Christ showed God to be gentle, loving, aware of our self-centeredness and shortcomings, yet deeply wanting a relationship with us. Jesus revealed that although God views us as sinners, worthy of his punishment, his love for us rolled and God came up with a different plan. God himself took on the form of man and accepted the punishment for our sin on our behalf. Sounds ludicrous? Perhaps, but many loving fathers would gladly trade places with their child in a cancer ward if they could. The Bible says that the reason we would love God is because he first loved us.